Hi, it's Patsy. I'm finally going to do the reading for you. Thank you for being so patient. This one kind of stumped me. I don't know if I'm being, what do they call it, punked, or if this is just an audition for something, or what. But with the bare minimum amount of information and with the barest minimum amount of contact, I'm going to try to see if I can contact between you and the person that you're interested in. I'm going to see if we can find out whether or not this is a twin flame, which is what you asked. And so I did my prayers and everything, and I got some cards for you. And maybe you're going on the right track here. This is looking promising. So let's see what the Oracle cards are saying for us, okay? So you are Sagittarius, and Sagittarius, I decided to, work with the inner child cards because that's what I was using last month, and for the generals. And Sagittarius, that would be the guardian angel card. Okay, so number 14, which would be temperance in the regular tarot deck, right? So, temperance, number 14, and I got this card so that, as your significator. Since you didn't have the full date of birth of your of the person that you're interested in, I didn't want to. I tried to do something that would at least even out the identification playing field for both of you. So I went with your birthdays, except for the. Okay, you knew that they were a Pisces and you are a Sag. So energy that is indicated for the Pisces is Cinderella. Guardian angel is similar to the fairy godmother in a way. And the card that in that is for Pisces in the regular tarot deck is the moon. Now the moon is mysterious and secretive, so that would be describing the situation as far as your friend is concerned here. So something mysterious and secretive, moon. Moon also talks about wishes and dreams. All right, so that were those were the two cards that would be indicating you and this person. So then I went to the gods and titans and goddesses and Simon's deck, which is by Stacy DeMarco and Tony Martin, and I got the energies for both of you. Energy I got for you was Vesta, Vesta, and Vesta talks about home. Oh boy, all right, we are not plugged in, but let's plug in. It should be okay. Right? Okay, so sorry about that. All right, so Vesta talks about home. So when I saw this, the first thing that came to my mind was that you feel comfortable around this person, you work with them, but you haven't had a chance to speak to them one on one. Well, at least you've only had a couple of times to be able to speak with them. But there's something about you that makes you feel familiar. That's why you're asking whether or not this is a twin flame. And that makes sense because when you feel like that, sometimes that would be an indication of this being some kind of connection because of the familiar way you feel about the person, right? Even though you don't have a lot to go on, this, you know, piqued your curiosity. So, the energy that came up for your partner, that's how I refer for him for the most part, was Green Man. Green Man talks about abundance, all right? This is talking about something that can grow, right? This is talking about the potential for growth and the potential for financial prosperity and abundance. Okay, and that may be an energy that you picked up on, which is why you're interested in this person. Okay, now we know the story of Cinderella, okay? Mistreated by her stepfamily, her stepmother and her stepfather, all right? But she had someone that came to her rescue unexpectedly, which was her fairy godmother, all right? And she ended up being vindicated, all right? And the godmother brought her what she needed in order to do what she was destined to do. Right? Now, guardian angel is an energy that looks over us, right? And guides us, protects us, and brings us to where we need to be. Takes us through, watches us as we go through our lessons, helps us when needed, as needed. So, Cinderella's godmother came to her needs, even after she went through a lot of struggle, right? Because the fairy godmother should have showed up when the evil stepmother was making Cinderella clean the chimney and all that other crap, right? Why she waiting just until there was a dance? But she waited because divine timing, right? Because there were things that Cinderella needed to go through. There were lessons that had to be learned. She needed to get to a certain age. The prince needed to be in the position that he was in, that he was looking for a wife. So things happened at the right time. Divine timing. So even though we're like, oh, where's this, you know, where's my prince, or where's my soulmate, or, you know, why am I not doing this, and why isn't this happening to me? All things work together for the good. Even the horrible bad things that Cinderella had to experience, but when the time was right, everything worked out in her behavior. But she had to be obedient, right? She had to know that she was told she needed to get out of that party by midnight, because if not, everything was going to turn to back. They were going to revert, right? And when some stories, some versions of the stories have her making it back in time, other versions have her getting stranded out in the forest with, you know, mice and a pumpkin, and no way to get home. I'm sure they didn't have an Uber or, you know, cab service back then, so how'd she get home? But some stories have her making it back to her home just in time for everything to revert back to the original form. Those of you who are not familiar with Cinderella, Google it. No. But I know you have to be familiar with Cinderella. And if you're not, you can Google it too, because basically it's the story of the glass slipper, right? And after the prince decides that he has to go out and find the person who's going to fit the slipper, that was the one that Cinderella left at the ball. They were able to, she was able to fit the slipper, and he married her and happily ever after, right? Okay, so we all know the story of Cinderella. Why one slipper didn't disintegrate, I don't know. Well, maybe neither slipper did. Maybe she got to keep one and he got to keep one, and that's how they were able to match him, besides her showing up and trying it on. Anyway, it's late and I'm telling too much of the story. You already know. Okay, so move on. So we got Green Man, who signifies abundance. And maybe since you work with this person, that may be relevant. Maybe that's another thing that may be attracting this energy, okay? Because he looks maybe like he's a stable person, and that's important. You know, at least you know he got a job. Very important. So, Vesta talks about home and stability for women, all right? This is a very, very feminine energy. And this is actually, I believe, the first time that it's come out since I've been using these cards, which hasn't been that long, actually. So I wanted to share it with you. All right. So Vesta talks about establishing a solid home base. All right. And it's also it also talks about protection is necessary or granted for the space around you. So if you have been looking for, if you've been asking for protection for yourself and your home, this says it's being granted. And if you haven't been asking for protection, you need to start asking for it. And this is telling you that you are being protected, basically. This said, it could also indicate that you may be moving from one home to another, okay? So, and you may want to be careful about fire around you and your home. Okay, so Vesta is the Roman goddess of home and hearth. As a key protective deity in Rome, a hearth containing a sacred flame would always be lit at her temples and shrines. So a hearth is like a fireplace, right? Ideally, these fires would not be allowed to go out, showing not only honor to the goddess, but also symbolizing the warmth and comfort of the home to its family. Vesta's temple in Rome was considered the sacred heart of the city. It contained a hearth, a large fire that burned constantly. A second fire, one of protection, was also within the temple. The Temple of Vesta was one of the only places of worship in Rome to be circular in design, and it was completely covered to keep the weather from snuffing out the holy flame. The saying, keep the home fires burning, was inspired by this practice. When the men in Rome left on military duty and their families prayed to Vesta in order to ensure their safe return and to keep the home fires of love stoked. So, the Roman soldiers went on duty. Their families prayed to Vesta to ensure their safe return and to keep the flames of love stoked. Vesta thus played a role as a protectress, not only of Rome itself, but also on the institution of the Roman family, wherever it may have extended to. Home was considered the dominion of women, and it was their responsibility to ensure its spiritual protection. What we know in most cultures, all cultures, the women are the keepers of the culture, right? This made Vesta a popular goddess with women who honored her
at the hearth, where they prepared food and cooked. They always gave some of the food back to the fire as an offering to Vesta for her blessings and protection. Again, offering to the ancestors, right, for protection. The priestesses of Vesta, the Vestales, were paid clergy. These women would serve the goddess. These women could serve the goddess only if they took a vow of chastity for 30 years. Hence the term Vestal Virgins. Okay. So a Vestal Virgin is someone who took a vow of chastity to remain single and virginal at least until they were 30 years old. So it was like a indentured virginhood, right? And they were paid. So that was that's interesting. Interesting. And Roman church now, and the Catholic Church, you can't be a clergy person if you're a woman. But back then, in Roman times, you were paid clergy. That was a job, and you were paid to serve the goddess and remain virgins. Center yourself and call the friendly fires of Vesta to bless your family, your home, and your space. If there's a conflict within your home or those in your house, she can help you with this too. If a loved one is away from home due to travel or work, she can offer protection. It's natural to experience many different feelings at home. Anger when in a fight, or a sense of being trapped when there doesn't seem to be enough space. Abandonment when an older sibling moves away or a parent is gone. Or even just irritation due to chaos and commotion. A lot of family members in the space. Even if it's a large space, right? If this is happening at your home, you can call on Vesta to help you with that too. Now, many cultures still consider a woman's place to be in the home, even if the woman does not always wish it to be. In general, women still do the majority of work within the home, although this is certainly changing. The home, while a sanctuary for most of us, can indeed become a prison or a place of isolation. It's important that if you're experiencing a true threat to your home, that you go to someone you trust to discuss and help bring an end to that situation. However, if you're simply feeling stifled, like many of us do in a busy home, do not lock yourself in your room and ignore the issue. Your space should be a protective space that you love, but you do not want it to become the only place in your home where you feel comfortable. You can also become obsessed with our space, the decoration, and the privacy, and the ownership. But this is not balanced. It does not reflect the grounded energy of Vesta. Now, she's represented by scepters, fires, hearths, sacrificial food, or cake, and Vestal Virgins. Okay, so again, maybe this green man here, your friend, guy that you're interested in, maybe there's, again, something about him that makes you feel comfortable, and he may represent stability. And so maybe that's what's piqued your interest in him. He may kind of fit the bill, all right? He would fit the shoe if you're dealing with the Cinderella analogy. So you want to see if he fits. You want to see if this shoe fits before you waste time getting to know him or wasting energy trying to figure things out about him. I got it. Now, I will say this. In the future, you work with the guy. You know what state you live in, or city, or whatever. Use the Google. Put in his name and his date of birth, and then you can at least get his year of birth. Come on, you know where he lives. You know what state he lives in. It's easier for you. I can't do all of that, you know. So, and you know his name. So I'm saying, use your detective skills. Think about these things. Now, maybe that's easy for me to think about because I used to do skip tracing for collections, but come on. If you have the person's first and last name and you know their date of birth, just put all of that into Google, and I bet you can find out the year of birth. Okay? At least. So, I was able to get two cards from the Romance Angel Oracle deck for you both, okay? So let's see what cards I got for you. Cards that I got that came for you were heart-to-heart conversations and engagement. Okay, this is in line with this. You need to talk to him. Okay, and start to get to know him. Don't be shy. Don't be, you know, don't hold back. Don't be shy. Get to know him. See if you like him. See what you have in common. All right, so again, engagement, meaning engage him in conversation. You know, have lunch, you know, together. I don't know what your job thing is, if you have cafeteria-style lunch. You know, okay, is anyone sitting here? Sit down and start up a conversation. Work in the same office area. There's got to be ways for you to be able to strike up a conversation with them. You know, so that's what I think would be the first step to finding out if, you know, more about them and letting him see your personality. All right. I don't know what the rules are, but of course you don't want to do anything that's going to get you in trouble, or you know, any kind of sexual harassment or anything like that. No, but there's nothing wrong, I don't think, with just talking to somebody that you work with. Maybe there's a project or something, or maybe you know, come on, people act like they don't know the answers to something. You could ask his opinion about something. I don't know what kind of work you do, but there's got to be ways, since you all worked in the same office, that you might be able to strike up a conversation, a meaningful conversation that can continue. You know, if it's about, well, you know, and ask, well, if he helps you with this thing, do you mind if I ask you, if I come to you again when I'm done, or do you mind if I run that by you one more time? You know, see what you think about it before I do this with it or whatever. Or, you know, just try to do something to keep the lines open so that you can get to know each other further. Okay? Now, the cards that came up with for him were passion and trust. Now, what also came up for him, because the next card that I got for the both of you were from the mermaids and dolphins. Now, passion and trust said to me that he's looking for something also. Not particularly from you, but I think that he is, this is saying that he's a passionate person. All right. And maybe this trust calling for you to have faith. Maybe he is also a faithful person. All right. But I think that this could be saying, this message could be for you, of course, because you're the person who's making the inquiry. Is that If you find that you like him after you start to talk to him more, that this could work out. And I'm gonna tell you why I say that, because from the Mermaids and Dolphins deck, which is also by Andromeda Virtue, the card you got was Make a Wish. This is a magical moment. Make a wish and enjoy its manifestation. And the card that came up for him was Synchronicity. Your prayers and questions are being answered by synchronistic events. Notice them in order to increase their flow. And what I got from this spread, just looking at it generally, is that he may be just as interested in you. That's the synchronicity. I think that's what it was trying to tell me, is that this he could be interested in you also. And if he is, then that would be another indication of a twin flame relationship. You have two dolphins in this picture, right? The dolphins are an indication of twin flames. There was something else that I wanted to point out to you, but it'll come to me. So, what this is saying to me is that you can manifest something out of this, at least a date to see whether or not this is something that is worth pursuing, a friendship, at least. I think that you would not get too much pushback from him, I think. It looks like he is a passionate person, all right? And he could be looking for someone just as well as you. So, let's see. Now, because you waited so long, I had gotten this deck of cards called the Lover's Oracle, and these are heart-shaped fortune-telling cards, right? They had come during last month, and they were marinating on the altar with the crystals and all of that. So I said, you know what, let me use it here, and let's see. And they're shaped like hearts. They actually have little heart shapes, right? And they're 45 cards. 45 cards. And we know 4 plus 5 is 9, and 9 is the ancestors. So, let's see. I was able to get 3 cards for you from this deck. And these were your cards. First card said, Romance, Cupid, Arrow, Strikes. So, that was your card. So, Cupid, Arrow, Strikes. Again, he may be just curiosity about you may be piqued also. All right, maybe you made a good impression on him, but Cupid has definitely pulled out his bow on you. All right, so this is saying to me that this could possibly be a romance. And the card that came for him, Sacred Union. Honor and treasure your relationship, for it is truly sacred. This, to me, could indicate a twin flame relationship. Now, if he's single, because I don't know if you know if he is or not, then cool. If he's not, then that means that the relationship that he's in already, maybe he may be married, or he may be already involved in a twin flame relationship. But because he got the synchronicity card, I'm thinking that he's available and free. Sacred Union says honor and treasure Your relationship for it is truly sacred. So he may, if this is a twin flame relationship indicating, I think it's saying that he'll be respectful of that once he figures it out or once he is made aware of it. Whether it's twin flame or not, I think that this is a guy that you could trust. A third card came up for you here in this reading from this Lover's Oracle deck. And it says, wait, don't rush into anything. Allow nature to take its course. So again, I think this is a potential twin flame relationship. I think that this guy is interested in you. And I think that he would be open to your advances if you do it carefully and in a respectful manner. And in a way that gives him a way, if he's involved with someone, you need to do it in a way that he will feel as if he can turn it down without making you feel any kind of way, all right? So keep that in mind when you do speak to him, when you do approach him, give him a way to be able to find a way to find out whether or not he's involved in a relationship before you put yourself out there. All right? If you know for sure that he's not, then go, you know, to whatever your next step would be. Like I said, if there's a way for you to just spend time sharing lunch, if you have a cafeteria, if you work in one of those offices where you eat at your desk and stuff like that, maybe you can offer him, you know, cookies or dessert or, you know, half a sandwich. Or if you're all ordering out, ask him if he wants to order out. He doesn't have to be the only person you order out with. Play it off, you know, like take orders for the day. Or if you want to, you know, bring in breakfast for everybody, bring donuts in for everyone, you know, or, you know, yeah, for everyone, or at least the people who work directly around you or something like that. But find a way to just give you an excuse to have a friendly exchange or more friendlier exchange that doesn't have much to do for work. What I'm saying is, you know, it doesn't have to be let's go out for drinks, because that kind of sometimes can set the wrong tone. So why not just see, you know, something mundane. You know, I guess you could ask him, did he watch the latest, you know, episode of Empire or whatever. But again, that's something that you can maybe hold off till you go out on a real date too. But at work, just to see, plant a little, you know, seeds of intention there. That, like I said, that's something you could do. If you can't afford to do that, maybe someone that you work with, who you're friendly with, if there is anyone else, you know, another girlfriend that works at the job, maybe the two of you together can bring in donuts one morning or bagels one morning, you know. Things like that. That's what I would have done back in the day when I was working in the office situation. You know. And again, you're taking a chance because he could be single, he could be available, but he just might not be interested. You know, you don't know what could be going on. But like I said, it pretty much, I'm pretty sure that he is because of the cards that came up here. So I'm just being a typical, like, you know, like a mom. And I'm like, I don't know, but I'm sure that it's just in this day and age with all of these, you know, people, you know, you want to be careful. You don't want to jeopardize your job. You don't know what people will do. And I just want to caution you to be careful. All right. All right. So from the Conscious Spirit Oracle deck, we get balance, number 29. 2 and 9 is 11, right? This is balance. Balance is also a card of temperance, and temperance is Sagittarius. So this with synchronicity and 11, yeah. This could be a twin flame relationship here. Definitely. I understand and embrace the opposing forces of in life that bring about balance. Lots of people meet their spouses at their places of business. Lots of people do. So I would say that you are on the right track. And number 40, at day's end rest, I find peace in nature and rest my body and mind in order to connect to spirit. So you work with this person. 40 is 4, which is foundational, at day's end rest. Okay, so maybe this is saying that you need to find some activity to engage him with him on your off hours. Yeah. If y'all go to happy hour or things like that, that may be a place where you can find yourself. If he's there, buy him a drink. Yes, buy him a drink. It ain't gonna kill you. It's an investment worth making. Yes. Yeah. When you're not at work, I think that's what it's saying. You can do this. You can make this connection better, of course, after work or on your days off. On your days off. Maybe. Maybe there's something that you can find yourself at. Maybe he goes to a local church that you can show up at. Or you can invite him to something at your church. You know, you can do that. You can invite him to go to church with you if you go to church. All these thoughts are coming to me of ways to connect. But I think that this is saying that definitely this is definitely potential here for that. But again, don't rush, right? Let nature take its course. I'm just trying to give you ways to give you some kind of way to at least let him know that you're, you know, interested like that. Because this is like the basic connection you have here. He may not know that you're interested, but I think that he's interested also. All right, yeah, definitely. You got 22 here, Archangel Gabriel. Again, a master number, master year. I invite Archangel Gabriel to bring hope and intuition into my life. Yeah, yeah. Following your intuition, this is confirming this. Yeah, this is a twin flame relationship. And the next card that came up, you got 21, 22. This is 21. Follow your path, your own path. I follow my own unique path with courage and strength. So have faith. Trust your intuition. I think that you are on the right path. Be patient. Wait. Don't get yourself into any trouble. Let nature take its course. But romance is indicated here, and a sacred union. All right. And these cards are all different on the back. This is on the back of your card. And this is on the back of his. So this looks like progression. And this is on the back of the weight card, so. All right. Going with the flow. I think that you're quite right in your assumption that this has the potential to be a twin flame relationship. And I think that the way for you to do is start off engaging him in conversation. See if you can schedule something for you all to do outside of work that'll bring you into contact with one another. It could be going out to lunch, it could be going out to dinner, it could be going to church, something. Maybe if you're having somebody you know is having a party, you can they could invite him too. Or you could throw a dinner party and invite some people over to your place and invite him also. Or you could get involved if there's a project at work the two of you can work on together. Or you could ask him for his opinion about something that you are doing. Not asking you to act like, helpless female, no. But I'm saying if something comes up and you can find a way to engage him, all right, and this way, showing him that you know what you're doing at work, right? So that he does, so that he knows that you have potential, you have a brain, that you do know what you're doing. Yeah, why not? But it would help, I would think. Google and find out at least his year of birth. Do some research. Y'all have all of this stuff at your disposal. Oh my goodness. If we had had these things when we were your ages, we'd have been more fierce than we already were at the time, because I think we were a very fierce generation of women, Ashe. Yes, we are. We were and we are. So, see if we can get something. Look, this is from the Rider Waite deck. Nine of Cups. Make a wish. You get your wishes. Okay, you got the Make-A-Wish card here. And here you have. You get your wishes. Love. Yeah. You're on the right track. You got this. You're on the right track. Follow your intuition, honey. You got this. You made an assessment and cards are saying that you have done very well. So what you can do is do some work with Archangel Gabrielle, all right, and ask her to help you to manifest this relationship further. All right, so you might not have to do any of the things that I'm suggesting if you talk to your ancestors and Archangel Gabrielle. If you're uncomfortable, then ask them to make a way. Ask them to establish order in this situation for you. If this is what's going to happen now that you've got these this confirmation, tell them to work it out and trust and have faith that they can do that for you. And they will. If they brought him this close to you, they could bring him even closer. All right. Just be careful. All right. But even though the card says wait, I don't think that you have to wait before you can start praying about it. All right. If this person has gotten you this. Has gotten you this interested after such a nominal amount of contact, and then you can get these kind of cards coming up in the reading regarding that, you can probably rest assured that your ancestors are going to step right up in there Knight of Cups. All right, so someone coming with an offer of love. This was you being indecisive. You weren't sure what did you want to do. Make up your mind. You're going to say something or not. Are you just going to keep admiring that person from a distance? Five of Swords. There may be other people that may be interested in him, but I think that this is saying to me that you can vanquish all of that competition. Or this may be saying that he may have just gotten himself out of a situation. So this may be that he is available. I don't know why I'm saying that for this card. But that's just the energy that I'm getting. Because if she's somebody back there crying, right, or upset, and this person is walking, but they're not, it doesn't look to me like they're walking exactly towards that person. It might be that they've noticed that they're there and they might be trying to avoid, you don't know whether or not they should go there. Yeah, I think that this is saying that you should, you can, feel confident in approaching him, that he'd be open to it. I know he would be. Yeah. Five. Okay. So, yeah, why don't you go along with that? You got the Nine of Cups. And the Knight of Cups. Yeah. All right. You didn't know which way to go. You were interested, though. And again, we have the Moon up here in the corner. And Pisces is indicated by the Moon. The Moon is a card for Pisces. Cinderella for him. Maybe he's just been waiting for somebody to come along and offer him the other slipper. Yeah, you could do this. I don't think it would be a bad thing. I think it would be at least an adventure. And this could be the start of something beautiful and big. No. We're not doing all that. That's too much. What? No. Oh, see, bottom of this deck here. Again, making a decision. Weighing your options, but it's a two. Yeah. High Priestess here. This is you using your intuition to get the victory. Moon card. Empress, you. Again. Yeah. Okay. Yes. This is a twin flame relationship, and I think that you can be comfortable in proceeding forward with that, all right, in a respectful manner. Speak to your ancestors just for further confirmation before you go out. Talk to them. Ask them to protect you in this situation. Ask them to protect your home. Make sure that you pay attention to fires around you. All right, you are protected, and protection means that you get warnings when stuff is going to happen also. That's part of the protection. So make sure your home is secure. Make sure that you aren't violating anything about your work conditions by talking to this person or dating them off site. But I definitely would do something to solidify this connection, at least. All right. Make him aware of you, because I think he already is aware of you. But If not, if he's just looking for someone, make sure that when he's counting up the places and people and things that he can see, that you are among the people that he can check off of the list. Oh, yeah, this girl at the job. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Make him aware of you is basically what I'm saying, okay? Anyway, dear, I hope that that answered your questions, and I thank you very much, and I will be talking to you soon, all right? Thank you for your interest, and be well. Let me know what goes on, okay? I'll be praying for you. Bye-bye.